will be a circle. Okay? So the path of the particle will be a circle. So, it means that we have the fact that when a charged particle moves in the magnetic field, if the velocity vector is perpendicular to the magnetic field, if the velocity vector is perpendicular to the magnetic field, we will have a circular path. If the velocity vector is perpendicular to the magnetic field, we will have a circular path. Okay? So that is we may call this a qualitative description of the motion. Now, when we know that the path is a circle, the next question is that what is the period of the motion? What is the frequency of the motion? Okay? And we can calculate that by simply put the magnetic force. Okay, you can see that this is a magnetic force. And you can see that because the magnetic field B is perpendicular to V, we have that the magnitude of the magnetic force is equal to the Q V B sine theta. But here theta is pi over 2. Okay? So order 90 degree. So sine pi over 2 or sine 90 degree is equal to 1. Okay? So you have that sine theta here is equal to 1. That's why we have that the magnetic force is equal to the V Q V B. But since we know that the path is a circular path and the magnetic force acts like a central force, so we have that on the right side, we have that this is equal to the FC, the central force. And the formula for the central force is the mv squared over r, right? FC is equal to mv squared over r. So we have that this is the magnetic force, and on the right side, it is the central force. And we put it together and do some algebra to get the radius of the circular path, or radius of the circle. The radius of the circle. Okay, if we look at this figure again, this is the radius. This radius r, okay, is equal to the mv over qb. R is equal to the mv over qb. That is the radius of the circle, the circular path. Okay. Also, when we talk about the motion of a particle under the central force, you can see that if we look back to this figure again, you can see that the force is perpendicular to the velocity vector. So we can also say that we don't have the component of the force in the direction of the velocity vector. So it means that the magnitude of the velocity vector is a constant. We can write here that the magnitude of the velocity vector is a constant. Okay? the magnitude of the velocity vector is a constant because we don't have the force, the component of the force in the direction of the velocity. So the force will change only the direction of the particle. It will not change the magnitude of the velocity. It will change the direction or change the direction of the velocity vector only. It will not change the magnitude of the velocity. Okay? So, it means that the magnitude of the velocity or the speed of the particle is a constant in this case. Okay, the speed of the particle is a constant in this case. And once we know the speed of the particle somehow, it depends on the problem, we can determine the angular velocity. Okay, the angular velocity. Or in the book they may say that it's an angular speed. The angular speed, which equal to the v over r, v over r, and if we put this r, if we put this r into this equation, if we put this r into this equation, we get that omega is equal to the q b over m. QB over M, that is the angular speed or angular velocity. And once we know the angular velocity, we know that the angular velocity is equal to the 2 pi F, where F is the frequency. The frequency of the motion. Like f is the frequency of the motion, and it means that we can write this in terms of the period, because the period is a reciprocal of the frequency. Okay. So we have this. So we have the expression for the period like this, and to get this 2 pi m over q b to be the period of the circular path. This will be very important later when we apply this result to some application. Okay, we will see that application soon. A more interesting result, but I will not prove it in the detail, is that we first talk about the motion of the shaft when the velocity is perpendicular to the magnetic field. Okay? What will happen if the velocity of the shaft is not perpendicular to the magnetic field? If it's not perpendicular to the magnetic field. For example, in this figure, you have the magnetic field in this direction. And you have the velocity vector in this direction. Okay? It's not perpendicular to the magnetic field. The velocity vector is not perpendicular to the magnetic field. So, what happened or what is the path of the charge? Okay? The point is that if the velocity is not perpendicular to the magnetic field, you can dissolve it into the okay. This is a little bit difficult to write because it is a three-dimensional. Okay, let's change the position a little bit. It's a little bit easier to write it here. This is the okay. If we write the component first, okay, something like this. Okay.